Today we're going to take this woman and apply the paint splatter effect. Hello and welcome to an Affinity Revolution tutorial. Today we'll be learning how to use the paint splatter effect. This effect will work on any photo, or if you'd like to follow along with me, I've included a download link in the description for the image I'll be using. The first thing we're going to do is select our rectangle tool, which is this blue box, and then drag a rectangle over our image. Now we're going to take this rectangle and drag it underneath our background image. Now we're going to add a new pixel layer by pressing on this button down here, and then drag our pixel layer to the top of the layer stack. We're now going to begin painting on our new pixel layer. To begin painting, we need to select our brush tool, which is this tool over here, or you can press the letter B, B for brush. And then we're going to come to the top right and select brushes. From here, we're going to change it from basic to texture. You can select any of these textures that you like, but I like Grunge 5. From here, it's as simple as painting wherever you want the paint splatter effect to be applied. So I'll click and drag, paint around her face a little bit, and then drag and paint around the rest of her body. Maybe paint some out here and over here. This is where you can really get your creative juices pumping and paint wherever you want, whatever you think looks good for your image. But for this video, I'll keep it brief and finish my painting there. Now we just need to take our background image and drag it underneath our painted pixel layer. Now we're going to come to our adjustments, this circle, and then select black and white. You can change these sliders however you want. I think I'm going to make my reds and yellows a little bit darker. Okay, that looks great to me. And now I'll exit out of that. And now we just need to come click on our rectangle layer and press Command J, J for jump. And this will duplicate our rectangle. With this new one, we're going to drag it to the top of our layer stack and then apply a gradient to it. We can do this by coming to our gradient tool, this colorful circle, and then clicking and dragging a line across our rectangle. This has applied a white to gray gradient, which is pretty boring, so let's make it a little more colorful, which we can do by clicking on this box and then clicking on the color box and choosing whatever color you want. I'm going to make mine purple, and then select this gray circle and press on its color box, and then change this to whatever color you want. I'm gonna make this one maybe a green. Yeah, that looks pretty good. When you're satisfied with your color, just press on this box again and it will remove the window. And all we need to do is come change the blend mode from normal to overlay. Perfect, that is looking great. As a finishing touch, we're gonna come to our adjustments and apply a brightness and contrast adjustment layer. I'm going to make mine a little bit darker and a little more contrasted, and then exit out of that. I think that gives the image a nice pop. And with that, we are done. Enjoy your new paint splatter effect.